It's your audiences only, so your mom is definitely invited. Sometimes controversial, always engaging. It's the podcast that lets your voice be heard. It's the podcast that shouts you out. It's time to holler. Can you dig it?
I could eat a unicorn one day through a Pop-Tart.
I like
Toaster strudels.
You like the jizzy part?
Yeah, I like the way it explodes. You like it? And to swallow it down. Oh my God.
Your tweets, snaps, Facebook comments, and even phone calls. Holler any way you want.
They used to give kids opiates to keep them quiet.
This is much less offensive than that.
JD, Brian, and Gracie, holler at your boys. And a girl.
And a girl. Well, and a girl. And a girl. Well, I will tell you, the girl's doing girl stuff right now because she's pregnant as fuck and she's up in the fucking hospital.
Wow.
She's about to have a baby, y'all. It's about to get real. So, what's up, everybody? Welcome to Holler. It's the podcast to shout you out. My name is JD. You can hit me up on the internet, JD Short. And over here to this direction is my good buddy, Brian. How you doing, Brian?
Hello, everyone. I'm the host that's not pregnant. The host that is pregnant is right here, and here she goes. She's typed the word I'm, and that sounds about right. They probably got her on the good stuff as she lays there.
That's awesome. Yeah.
Like the duffel bag that she is ready to produce a child. I can't say without loud.
She's trying to get unpregnant. Yeah,
you know,
you go.
That is one way to look at it, actually. She's at the hospital to become unpregnant.
Right.
I won't take that any further than what I just said. We are going to play a game this evening, though, and it's going to be called Who Can Guess What Time the Baby Will Be Born? It could be any time between right now, live on the show, or into tomorrow. So whoever gets the closest, we are going to mail you some CAMO Energy for free, $3.99. We'll talk more about that later, because obviously our guest this evening is Adam Mallory of CAMO Energy. What's up, Adam?
Yo, yo, yo. What's cracking?
Dude, always good to have you here, man. And you've got some exciting stuff to show us. Like right out of the gate, I want you to show off those new labels on these shots because these people haven't seen these new labels yet.
Do you have a blood orange with you?
No.
I have an old boy, OG boy.
You can see show them the difference between the two labels. There you go. So you guys are used
backwards, but that's okay.
You guys are used to the middle screen right there with JD. That's what you've been getting in the mail, but you're going to start getting the other. You're going to start getting that over there with Adam. And look at that. So it's got the chartreuse. That's their color of choice.
Correct.
It's got the chartreuse lid on top of it.
Yeah.
And so that way, if they're in like, you know, if they're on the door in Speedway and different places like that, and you're looking down on them, you're going to see that button pop on top right there. Look at that. That's so cool.
Yeah. That's why I was asking you if you've seen them in a Speedway yet, because they're just gorgeous when you go in there, you know, next to the, that 5 hour garbage, but
garbage.
Yeah, dominating.
And the tiny little crappy little bottles with the tiny little tops on them. These are fucking straight up real deal delivery systems right here. That's real. Yo, CAMOEnergyShots.com is where you can get them, but we're going to give away a bunch. So if you guys share this live feed, yes, Miranda, they do look so good. If you share this live feed and send us your information, we will hook it up. Brian, how does that work? Can you tell them how it works?
Yeah, absolutely. If you guys share the live feed to your Facebook wall right now, just make sure you DM us with your mailing address. That's all you have to do. After sharing it, we're going to see that you shared it. We're going to mail you a 2-pack of CAMO, random flavors, and it's for free. You don't have to pay shipping, you have to pay anything. Just make sure you DM us your mailing address. Don't forget that part. So share it first. Share the video right now to get more people in here. Let's have some fun with it.
Brian, I believe it's time for you to do a toast. Then we're going to talk CAMO. Oh, hell yeah.
Miranda says,
they look as good as Adam's calves. Yeah.
We got ourselves a good old-fashioned calf competition. I'm sure. Here we go.
Yeah. Those chartreuse calves.
Brian, why don't you give us a good toast, and we'll scoot on and talk a bit more CAMO and tell you all about the new business that's going on with them and all the good stuff. And
absolutely. Listen, we got a shout-out, Andrew, in the house of the Shotgun Squad. We hooked Andrew up with some CAMO last week. As a matter of fact, Adam, you'll be interested in this story. So this is Andrew out of Texas. He's part of Shotgun Squad, one of our other sponsors. And, are you going to say something about Texas? What's up?
It's a major focus right now. There's active conversations with major players out of Texas. So, what a coincidence.
So soon enough, Andrew, it sounds like you could probably just go grab yourself some camo right off the shelves there. We'll just leave that cat in the bag for right now. But yeah, we definitely hooked him up, sent a bunch his way, and he was very appreciative of it. But we did it out of love, man. Out of love. We love you back. Fantastic. We got DJ illSpin in the house. Former guest. Nice. DJ illSpin. What's up, dude? Absolutely.
What?
Yeah.
West Virginia in the place to be. Okay. Yes.
Andrew said, I just so happen to be a major player in Texas. Dot, dot, dot. It depends on what kind you want. All right, guys. Hey, listen, if you're out there in Holler Nation, hold your drink up right now. Hold your shot up. We're going to toast and get this thing started. Gracie is laying there in a hospital bed right now. She's about to give birth. She could be giving birth right now. Gracie, if you're hearing this and you've already given birth, hold your baby in the air, your new baby, to this toast right here. We'll get this show going. All right, guys, here's the Holler toast. Let's get this show kicked off. Vincent Van Gogh, people told him, you cannot be a great painter. You only have one ear. And you know what he said? I can't hear you.
Link up at officialholler.com.
Cheers. Cheers to Gracie's unborn or newborn baby.
Unborn yet, newborn yet, betwixt born. It's Schrodinger's baby, maybe?
It's in the mail.
It's a maybe baby. It's in the mail. It's being shipped.
You've got mail.
You can track
it. You've got mail.
Oh, boy. What up, Holler Nation? How are y'all doing? We're going to have some fun tonight. We are... He's still in her body, she says. She is reporting live
the
from
the baby. Baby
this
is
so wild. This is so
Oopsie.
This is so wild because Gracie, I mean, technically could be on the show. If she wanted to pull her phone up to her face, you know, she could be on it. But you know what? We're not gonna bother her with that because this is a major life event here that she needs to have all the attention on the real deal thing, but I bet there have been people that have fucking TikToked their baby delivery. Don't you think?
Well, dude, 100%. You see the world we live in?
Of course the world we live in now, somebody has fucking Twitched or Facebook Lived their baby.
Well, Gracie, you know, and she, in all fairness, this is the world we live in, and she probably did this for family. I'm going to give her the benefit of the doubt. I'm not going to be mean to you, Gracie, because you're listening, but Gracie did, like, on Facebook, she has checked into Cabell Huntington Hospital, like as a check-in. It's like a fucking notification I got on Facebook. Gracie is checked into the hospital. I'm like,
I get any Foursquare rewards on here.
Yes, I'm in. I want the notification that's like, Gracie is on her fourth push. Push number five coming out.
The pusher app.
She says she'll go live from Holler. We did think about this was the idea of Niles, one of our former guests as well, and Gracie's bestie. Niles said that we could put a camera on Gracie as she's pregnant, laying there, but we don't know when she's going to give birth. And it will be like the cameras that were on, like the giraffe when everybody was logging in, watching the giraffe. And then, like, you know, finally, eventually the giraffe gives birth and it's like it's the live birth of Gracie.
It's like, we knew exactly the moment that it happened. Well, you know. We're going to know anyway. It's going to be funny because I have a feeling it's going to happen while we're streaming now, like while we're live. Right? Oh, Krayshawn had Blueface Baby on live. See? All right. illSpin already knows. illSpin already knows. So,
do they hold the baby up? Like the baby's like dripping. They're like, look.
Covered
check it
in
out.
Stuff and everything, dripping.
That's when you do the water birth.
Still caught in. Still back in.
Still corded. One on the vine.
One on the
y'all smash that subscribe if you love this baby right here. It's fresh.
It's still dripping.
It's still dripping.
Look at the drip on this baby. It's physical.
Look at that drip. Yeah, that's what it is.
Oh God, that's horrible. Well, so anyway, Adam, how you doing, brother? What's up in the world of CAMOEnergyShots.com, baby?
Oh, bobbing and weaving every day. This this retail space, I tell you, it's an interesting one. Very hard to understand, very challenging to navigate, but somehow we're still here and still growing the brand.
Especially on such a big level, you know, you guys have now been kind of national for a hot minute now. What are the sort of things you're running into now that you've had a bit of time kind of in that situation, you know?
Yeah, so you know, what makes this space so challenging is not being Coca-Cola, not being Frito-Lay, and, you know, it's not enough to have a good idea, to have some solid resources, and then have a sound product.
Yeah.
You think that's all it would take in a few relationships. It's just, it's very challenging to navigate. So what we've been doing for the last couple of years, essentially, is running a pilot program. And yes, yeah, we're in 27 states through various retailers, but we are on the brink of cracking the silver bullet accounts. And I was explaining to B-Ball before we started, we have a massive meeting next Wednesday that could change CAMO's fate overnight. So a lot of that stuff I like to keep to myself as far as the players involved until it happens. But yeah, I mean, there's some very exciting things going on and it's very fluid. The issue with retail is how slowly things move. You know,
yeah, it's so wild. It's so wild how that is when you're creating new product and you're putting out new stuff. Again, like the beginning of the show, we were talking about the current labels you got.
Yeah.
And the new stuff is so much hotter. It's these are still dope as fuck and they're great.
Right.
The colors are wonderful and these are classic. And as a matter of fact, I still hang on to a couple because I bet they'll be fucking worth something a little bit more in the future.
Well, listen, but, dude, I've been saving since this project started. I mean, you guys have watched how many times we've had to pivot.
Right.
And I've saved all of these different, you know, items in the think tank, marketing material, whatever it is. So we're going to do a revision on the whole warehouse here soon. And I'm going to have a whole area that's going to be pretty much the history, the lineage of the CAMO brand.
Yeah, like a museum.
Correct.
Dude, we're all on the same page with that. I actually saved what I call the CAMO fleet. Yeah. I have the entire CAMO fleet in a cabinet in my kitchen, and these are the ones I show on the show, not the ones I drink. I have one of each flavor that's ever existed, going back to CAMO CBD, as a matter of fact.
Very
I got the
nice.
Whole fleet.
Yes.
You should do it. Like in the Museum of CAMO, make sure you have like a – do like an animatronic of Brian. You know, like it's like CAMO began in Huntington, West Virginia.
Yeah, I'll have to put that.
Share the stream. Yeah. Share the stream. Share the stream.
I'll put that in the budget for sure.
You got a. This is the second sponsorship request for CAMO of local artists, man. And these are good ones too, by the way, that we're getting. So we've got Corduroy Brown once in. We've got Shalim and illSpin once in. This is the area I want to be into one day, by the way. I want to help in this area. Hell yeah.
Absolutely. Until, DJ illSpin, you know, the 2024 marketing budget is being discussed this fall. So I'll put his name in the hat. And of course, that's all predicated on how Sunday goes, of course.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, I see. Cause see, not everybody knows this, but there's a kickball situation going on Sunday that the dudes are all up in and it's about
to I'm an Indian outlaw.
It's wild though. You lined it up with week one of NFL and that's nuts. But I would really hope that somebody's going to have a TV out there so that we can
watch. Yeah, there's actually no excuse to not do that these days. You're exactly right. hey, we got Mel on the West Coast in the house. Mel, you already know what I'm going to ask you. Are we in Alaska today or are we in Oregon today? Where are we coming from? Hey, Mel loves her some CAMO energy.
Try that with fudge rail.
Mel, if you would, Mel has no idea what that means. Mel, if you would,
Nobody does because it's provocative.
It gets the people going, dude.
People going.
Mel, if you would just share this live video to your wall, and DM us and remind us that you did that, we'll send you some CAMO as always.
I like your profile pic right there too. It's very pretty.
Yeah, dude.
Very good.
Yeah.
Keeping it real. Thank you, Mel. So again, remember everybody, CAMOEnergyShots.com. illSpin's loving it. And you already know what it is. Mel says, I'm still in Alaska for work. She has 10 more days. So a week and a half, and you're back to, I guess.
Okay, I've got the weirdest question for you, Mel, while we've got you here. So you're in Alaska right now. We know that we've shipped you a ton of CAMO energy it's like a couple years now. Anyway, have you ever traveled to Alaska with any of your supply of CAMO energy? Because if you have, that means, Adam, your supply of CAMO energy has touched ground in Alaska, which would be pretty fucking cool if you think about it.
Travels well. I can tell you that.
You know what? And that's a fantastic point. Adam, I've got a question. It's wonderful
served cold, like up in Alaska. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, you're right. Just pop it right in the snow.
Ice fishing.
First you can try. Yeah, it's perfect for ice fishing. That's your next market, dude. Ice fishing. We're coming up on it. That's your crowd.
Love it.
Focus on that fucking hole in the ice right there. You're trying to rip that fish out. There's only like a couple in there. Do you see them or not? Like the other ones, they're not moving. Adam, how hard... hold on, we got Grace in here. She says, you're sending me a three-month supply of camo when I got home with this new baby, right? Question mark.
Well, once the baby gets off the teat, I will.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Because you got
that baby.
You can't be pumping young, right? Camo.
Got to start them young. I just got this baby fresh. It loves camo.
It loves camo energy. Which, by the way, just letting everybody know, it has 250 milligrams of caffeine, carbs. There's no sugar. It's 100% flavor. They taste wonderful. It's good shit. Oh, illSpin said he's taking it to Florida and Chicago. That's what's up.
Oh, this is so cool. Check this out. So Mel says, nice. I had my camo shipped up to my camp in Alaska, and I've given them to residents around our camp. How cool is that, dude? I'm telling you, man. These are the...
She's like going up to him going like, yo, it's that real shit.
Gracie,
it's that mainland shit. You can't even get this.
Gracie says she can officially drink one a day and he'll live. And so I'm assuming that Gracie's even talking about like on the cord, like when she's got one on the vine, still she can throw some camo down.
One on the
vine. Has she been induced yet?
Hashtag one on the vine. Saving it.
The fact that I'm holding like this, like it's like a rope,
like a fish,
like it's an
ice. She just caught at the lake.
Yeah.
Hey, ask Rashad, what's your favorite or flavor?
Oh, yeah. Let us know your favorite flav. Your
Ooh,
flavor
good point.
Flav.
Same with you, Mel. I think I know what Mel's is, but I want to hear Mel and
illSpin. Hashtag what's your favorite?
What's your flavor, dude? illSpin has another twist on it. It's on the water hose. Finn on the hose. I don't like where this is going, but Gracie is about to get her cervix ripened.
I can't tell what the emoji is that she sent with it. There's definitely an emoji. But is there a cervix emoji? Do we have the ladies? Can you confirm?
Or the umbilical emoji. That is, I don't know. Dragon fruit is the choice of illSpin, by the way. And
yeah, great choice. That one, and Rocket Pop got us into Speedway. So
hey, a couple things. Everybody, share this live video right now to your Facebook wall. DM us your mailing address. We will mail you this stuff for free. That's all we're asking. Just share it. As a matter of fact, if you want to win twice, I'll give you a second reason. Go to our YouTube. Find us on YouTube. Go give us a follow, subscribe to us, show us that you subscribe to us. I'll double it. I'll double your free order tonight since we got camo on here. Why not? So illSpin, go give us a follow and they'll give me a reason to bring you even more camo.
You need to do something with this.
Yeah. True. Like a grand prize kind of deal. I like it.
Dude. Yeah, dude. That's stuff so sick.
Oh, hey, so he also likes the blueberry blast, Mel says she loves Rocket Pop and Dragon Fruit. And Mel, we're on the same exact page, by the way, because that's what I always have with me on here to show off. These are my two favorites.
They're wonderful. I really, really dig the lemon frost, especially as a mix with some other good stuff.
You're on to something right there.
You can make a lemon drop martini that sets the night off so well with one of these. I say Deep Eddie's lemon flavored vodka. Drop this in there with it with some really good triple sec or maybe Cointreau, and then just shake it till it's cold as hell. Serve it with a nice little twist of lemon.
Yeah, you know what? We might JD, the next time you make one of those, because JD's a bartender here. Okay, this is no fucking around. He actually works at a bar.
Well, I'm a bit late today. Actually, we're pretty fucking busy tonight.
That's why he was a little bit late because he's pouring those drinks. Hey, illSpin, we appreciate you, man. I see you out there. Thank you for that subscribe. We appreciate it. But no, JD, the next time you make one of these, let's take a really nice photo. Let's post it on Holler for the people to see.
Oh yeah, for sure. I gotta get some of that new label stuff, and we'll make something real sick with it.
Sure,
for real.
She says, Gracie says that she's got her YouTube link. By the way, illSpin says Rocket Pop is the fire. No doubt about it. Here is the YouTube link. It's going to be in the comments, guys. So if you haven't subscribed to us on YouTube, and if you don't have a YouTube, go sign up for one and then go subscribe to us. We'll send it to you for free. It's a reason for you to get more camo. By the way, Mel says, if you could send me one of those drinks to my camp, JD, that would be great because it's so delicious. Right,
I'll do you one better. We'll get a really good photo with it. I'll make the recipe and we'll make sure that everybody knows what's up. It's absolutely awesome. I fucking love this shit.
Dude, hey, JD, hear me out here. Hear me out. Okay. Since we've got traction right now, we're going to talk about camo literally the entire show. Let's go ahead and give some away. Let's play some Family Feud. Why not?
I'm loving it. I think it sounds absolutely wonderful. Let's do it.
Do it, bro. It's time to win some. Let's go.
We'll try that in a fudge round.
Try that shit in a fudge round. All right. So right now, this round right here, this fudge round that we're about to play, we're only going to go to two. So first one to two.
Here we go. For real. We'll do it. Yeah, let's do two-point rounds. That's what we should do. So
yeah, exactly.
It'll maximize. It'll keep it action-packed, and it will maximize not only the flavor, get it? CAMOEnergyShots.com. But it will also maximize the fun. It's going to be a good time. And we still got poll questions to do and all that good stuff as well. So
it's Family Feud time. Here we go. All right. And JD, I'll let you talk to Camo in the background. I'll go ahead and take Gracie's role of I'll fire the question and I'll figure out the winner on my end. Whoever's first on my end, guys, your end's going to be a little bit different than my end because your internet's faster. Okay, here we go. Looking for the number one answer. First question. Name a profession in which you travel to meet with clients. Name a profession in which you travel to meet with clients. Question number one.
Well, actually, speaking of that, that's a really cool transition too, because obviously, Adam, I might not necessarily be you particularly, but anybody with camo, you've been traveling, right? Like meeting with some peeps, getting some stuff done. Where are you kind of going? Where you been? What's up with that whole situation?
With said the brand? Earlier,
how many? Well, yeah, with the brand, and also like, how many states did you say? You said 27.
Yeah, we're in 27 states, and right now there's a huge focus on the southern border from Florida all the way to California. And if you look at the analytics, they suggest that's exactly where we should be. The highest consumption of the energy shots and caffeine in general are through the South, and then it's trickles in to the Northwest and then back to the Northeast and then down to the Southeast. So just like everything about this brand is calculated, so is our approach. So we're just following the analytics. We're going where the fish are.
Yeah. Number one answer is in the chat. Hey, Mel, while we've still got you here, since you're in Alaska and we keep talking about this, because I just think it's so cool, what's the chances that we've got Camo Energy in Alaska potentially? Do us a favor. The next time that you're straight up in Alaska and you've got camo on you, if you could take a picture with like some kind of Alaska background with that camo energy, take us a few pictures, send them our way or tag us. We will send you a case up there. We'll send you a 12 pack just for doing that for us because that's cool shit. And we appreciate you. And we got nothing but love for
us. You're straight up. You are a Holler representative and therefore as well a camo representative. And that's how we go.
Yeah. And just give me the heads up. Tag camo. I'll let the marketing team know. They can drag it over and all that.
100%. Man, see, these guys are awesome. This is why we have them on the show, guys. And this is why they're our proud sponsor. This is why we give this stuff away. It's not just because we love it so much, but we do. And it's not just because they give us some freebies, because they do. But look, they give it to you too, and they're cool as shit. That's why we have them here. Number one answer, by the way, is a salesperson or a salesman. We've got Miranda on the board with 1 point. So
there you go.
I have to do Gracie's job. I got to keep track of her. This is tough, Gracie. I don't want to do this.
Up, man, you got to keep it up.
Okay, here we go. Next question. Oh, she said challenge accepted. She's going for that camo. It's going to be so cool. I'm so pumped, Mel. Please do that for us, man. You're awesome. We love you. Seriously. Okay, here we go. Next question. Looking for the number one answer. Name something people chase. Name something people chase. Okay. This is a weird one. This is interesting.
I'm all right. I'm excited to see the answers that aren't right. This one's like, yeah, there you go. I'm really, you know, and it's another thing too. It's Brian was talking about, like, you know, we've been working with camo for a hot minute and we love it. And it's so fantastic, but it's also just so cool that you guys come on our show and you're super transparent with how you care about your branding and how you work with the customer. And it's like, you guys are literally, I said this, I think last time you were on the show, we were all together. I said something about like, it's so much fun when you do our show, you're kind of giving us these are like business tips. Like if y'all are trying to build your own brand, check out every CAMO show and watch them evolve, and it's going to make your shit better. Like,
you know, yeah, what's great too about the CAMO Energy shots, it evolved from an entirely different direction we were going. Excuse me, I got the hiccups here, but
it's all right. You know,
we were challenged by our Anheuser-Busch partner that if we came up with an energy shot, we could not produce enough once he started making phone calls because of his contacts throughout the AV network. And that's
a challenge accepted.
Yeah, exactly. So my brother and I looked at each other, and I mean, it's we're all friends and business partners in the same room. But me and my brother are like, oh, it's on. That's how CAMO came to be. Yeah.
So that's a sporting event to you. That is a challenge. That's a sporting challenge to 100%. You.
Makes it better. It's like, makes it taste better. Ride, even. Yeah. Hey, number one answer is in the chat, by the way. Number one answer is dogs. That's the number one thing people chase. Rachel is on the board.
Wow. I did not expect that one. That's honestly why I think it's a weird one. I thought it would have been tail.
Rachel! We did have some good answers.
I've missed that sound. That sounds wonderful. Oh, okay.
People do chase mouse. People chase mouse.
People say chase mouse.
People chase mouse. People chase
ice cream truck.
Ice cream truck. People chase dreams.
People take
and money.
People chase the money. Chase the money.
People chase that kitty.
The kid. Ooh, them bongos.
Sometimes
I don't know if y'all heard the new Cardi B. The new Cardi B and Megan Thee Stallion fucking hit.
Granted, hits. Being biased. Whoa. She says B-ball. That's right. They chase basketball.
Granted, does chase B-ball. That's true. for real, before we can, have either of you guys heard bongos yet from Cardi B and Megan Thee Stallion?
I am not sure.
Highly recommended listen. It's a fantastic spiritual successor to WAP. I'm just saying.
Spiritual. Oh, to WAP. Very nice.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And to quote my buddy Patrick, when I asked him what the song was about, he said, it's about how good they pussy is.
And on that note, here comes your next question. We're looking for the number one answer. This is a weird one too. I like this one. We got a couple people that could win it right now. Rachel could win it. Miranda could win it because we're going to two. Here we go. Name a professional who it wouldn't be strange to see in your bedroom. Ooh. Name a professional who it wouldn't be strange to see in your bedroom.
This one's got this one's got a little worded weird. This one's
worded got weird too.
So this is a fun one. Beautiful. Obviously, when you talk to everybody about the branding and all that good stuff, you know, it's great. And we talk about all the different flavor options and everything that CAMO offers. But what is some of the more interesting flavor ideas that people have come up to you and said, you know what, you should do a CAMO that tastes like this? Like, what are some of the weirdest ones or most interesting ones people have thought of?
Those requests have been pretty straightforward, but what I will say is there's two flavors coming out in Q1 that are going to blow people's minds. And the only reason I don't want to disclose those is because I don't want a competitor to catch wind of them.
Good.
We've rocked it, and the branding on it, I mean, it's all buttoned up. It's happening. It's sweet. Gorgeous branding, flavor profiles are obnoxiously good, and I can't wait to come out with those.
Well, you're hitting it out the park. The rocket pop just doesn't stop. The rocket pop don't stop. Once you rocket pop, you don't stop.
And you guys like ran out of that flavor because it was like so popular, right?
Oh yeah, absolutely. That one did very well, and you know that one was in this retail space. You have something called LTOs, limited time offer. It's just a total marketing approach, and it works. It gets consumers dialed in. Oh, I'm gonna miss out, that whole concept. That flavor did so well that if you guys remember me telling you, it performs second only to five hour energy watermelon in our biggest market. So we made it a mainstay. Yeah,
that's so gnarly because that was that's a huge hit. That's a huge ass hit. And this one right here too. I keep popping this one up. Obviously, these are my two faves because I keep popping them up. Yep. But the dragon fruit, I'm telling y'all, this is a flavor explosion in the face. And also, it's like you can't get something that tastes like this any the fuck where else. I'm telling you.
That's actually a fact too. And we'll piggyback on that in a second. Number one answer is actually in the chat. I almost gave up on you guys, and then illSpin came through with the number one answer. It is Painter. That's the number one answer.
You've reached in there.
You guys are talking about like professionals in your bedroom, like like ghost hunters.
Oh, you know, because I get those every other week.
Or butlers.
Oh, all right, illSpin. We know how you live now, but all
divorced lawyers, or maybe the exterminator. That's actually not a bad guess.
That's pretty good. That's pretty good.
But Painter was it. illSpin's on the board. You guys are keeping the game going. Here we go.
The game is still alive, y'all. It's real. It's real.
Sure do wish I had Gracie here writing these down instead of me, but here we are. Okay. Gracie, are you still alive out there? You still got it on the cord, or what's going on?
Let us know. Are you still dang? Are you dangling from a string just yet?
Pull that thing out.
She's dilated. She's dilated to seven. I don't know when it
comes
out.
Is that what she says?
She's at seven. She's dilated to seven.
Did she say that?
That's just a hunch.
Oh, I was like, I have no idea.
Okay. Wait, he's calling it. Wait a second. I got to pull out the sports book real quick. I got to hit the... I got to pull the numbers up and see.
Is the water hose still attached to the house? And it's Tracy, we need to know. It's the middle hose.
Oh, boy.
Gracie has an update. She is at one.
One? Jesus, she's going to have the baby in fucking November.
Our new guest is the 13th of September, days away.
I don't need both on there, Woozy.
Okay, here we go, guys. Next question. We've got some people about to win. Here we go. Name a warning sign your relationship is about to end. Name a warning sign that your relationship is about to end.
Okay. All right.
Fair enough.
Say word. That's what's up. So I'm going to go a little sideways on this one. You guys were talking in the pregame before the show started about there is the Jewel City Kickball League is having their championship weekend this weekend. And it's a big party. You guys, what's your ranking right now? And who do you face first? And what's your strategies?
We are ranked number two. I'm not sure who we play first. I'm just focused on the strategy, which is getting to the championship and retaking what is rightfully ours.
Exactly. And
last year was a major fluke. It was monsoon. I think somebody actually drowned and died at the field.
Fucking lightning hit a tree, set it on fire. Yeah. God was coming to us last year.
It was literally acts of God were occurring around you the whole time. And you guys were just
Our team has been ranked. Our team has been ranked number two going into the tournament before. We've been there, done that. And we won that year. So we're just hoping to bring those same vibes.
I forgot to say too, but you won't know who you're playing until the first game. Cause the first game determines who your shit. illSpin said, damn, he said a fluke.
I mean, in all fairness, illSpin, it was once out of 12 years finally. So
yeah, bro. I mean, if it was any other sport,
ideally we would be playing Rashad's team in the finals. And
there you go. But yeah, we see on the other side. He's on the other side of the bracket.
It's competitive. Yeah. It's fun, but it's a lot of fun. The tournament, the whole day, it's a really good time.
And there'll be there'll be plenty of camo there as well. So if you are in
the number one answer has been in the chat. The number one answer has been in the chat. It was the second one guess. It was the winner who is
Rachel
is your camo energy winner for round one of tonight. We're gonna go round two here in just a bit. You guys gotta stick around. Done, Rachel. Make sure you send us a DM so that we can mail you this because we'll forget otherwise. And
look at her profile picture too, everybody. It's so pretty. Look at her hair.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, you guys come up with a game for this, and I'll put some merch in it, some camo pins. I'll get it loaded up.
Okay.
All right.
We'll do a real deal. We'll do a real deal, like Tournament of Champions thing for that one.
Yeah.
That's a great prize, boy. And we'll also include some Holler merch with that, too. Some, like, one of them like can't get it anywhere else.
What's cool about this, this is an actual ammo kit, by the way.
Yeah, for real.
Ammunition.
illSpin said, I'm still laughing at Fluke. I'm about to log off.
illSpin said, I'm taking that back to my team on Sunday, giving him a pep talk. You know what? Do it, man.
Do
Be
it,
Superman.
Bro.
Be Superman, bro. Go tell him.
Damn fun.
Yeah, we're going to have some fun. We're going to have some fun on Sunday. Let's do it.
Yo, so there's also – so we've been playing games and doing all this stuff. We've been giving you multiple chances to win camo, by the way, all night long. If you can't win it or just, you know, you still want to just know more about the company, it's wonderful. Go to CamoEnergyShots.com. They'll tell you everything about it, show you all the stuff. You can order directly from them. It's great. They ship them right to your place. You can get as much as you want. It's absolutely fantastic. illSpin says snitches get stitch.
Hey, now that he's loving the Fluke comment, I think the bigger Fluke was the team that got a hold of them, because we should have been playing them in the championship last year.
Yeah. He knows all about – yeah, he should know all about Fluke. You're exactly right. Adam, here's a weird camo question for you, and I think that this is an interesting story. Because I've talked to you a little bit about this personally, but when you guys do a label change and you bring out that cool chartreuse lid and you bring out those cool new graphics and things like that, how long from the idea, from conception of the idea until it's on a shelf at Speedway? How long?
Well, just the, you know, hold on, guys.
Yeah, no worries. Fine. You're fine. It's all good. I'm over here pouring up.
Ox. Gear down.
I'm over here pouring up.
Age. Chill out. So the whole conception.
School's back in session, man. It's all about energy right now.
Yeah, the whole concept and getting that to production is about 6 months, but then getting a retailer, that's a whole different question, or excuse me, whole different answer. I spent 2 years on this Speedway trial. So. Wow. Yeah, that's a whole different animal. And that's where I'm talking about is at any moment, this has the opportunity to blow up and it'll look like, you know, Camo just came on the scene. No, Camo has been putting in work for years to get on the scene. And that's where we are right now.
This is exactly why you see these brands that seem like they're brand new, right? And then you'll see them put out like merch or like a t-shirt or something, or their website. And it will say like established in 1912. You're like, damn, what? It took 111 years.
I never heard of that root beer before.
Yeah. And
you mean my great grandpappy?
It's the way you try to expedite these things is getting plugged in with the right network of folks. Right. And that's what Camo's been, you know, trying to do is find a like-minded group that's going to take us to the next level, because you're talking about two guys that built this brand that came from medicine, right? Orthopedic trauma. That's my specialty. That's my background. My brother's neuro and spine. So we had to come in and learn this space and align ourselves with the right people. And we finally done that. And I love the path it's going in and the trajectory, but the timeline I do not like, and it's driving me nuts.
Well,
hello.
I think that that's a situation, just like a lot of things. It's almost like, and the closest thing I think I could relate it to, and I can't even relate it to, would be like becoming a successful musician. It's like you are putting in so much work, and it seems like you're putting it in so much on this front end, and then all of a sudden you go fucking viral. Like, you know.
Well, and, you know, it's kind of the concept, nobody knows about you until they do, right?
Right. Yeah.
They have no clue.
And nobody cares until everyone does.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. And for us, the space we're in, it takes a lot of money and the right people. And that's what we're on a capital raise right now, you know, to continue this transparency conversation. We're on a capital raise and we're bringing in M's, and 40% of that raise is going to go towards marketing. And it's a national marketing plan that honestly, we've been trying to launch for about 18 months. But
that's a long time.
Yeah, you have to pay attention to, you know, your cash flow and make the right decisions.
Hey, you've got a great question in the chat right here from illSpin. What are the health benefits of drinking camo? And I already have some ideas. Let's talk about some buzzwords. Let's go.
Yeah, absolutely. The biggest thing for us, and what a great question. And in my conversations last week with a major retailer, which is the number one player in the country, I touched on this, which is the differentiator with camo, and it's the neuro component. And you guys, let's go back to the beginning when we put this liquid together. It was focus groups. It was neuroscientists. I mean, we really brought a medical clinical component to this liquid. This is not a white label product. It's our baby. We made it. But one of the things my brother always wanted was that mental focus. And you get that with that L-theanine. And that was my brother. It's not dumb luck or anything. So now fast forward to 2023, when Joe Rogan and everybody's talking about nootropics and all of these other things. Well, guess who's been there and didn't even realize it? Little old camo.
Yeah.
So that is using, one of the biggest benefits is that
using the ingredients y'all use and the choices how you are, because these are, again, these are energy shots. So when you think of energy shot, you think, oh, okay, it's going to provide me with, you know, a bit of this, a bit of that. You know, they're completely, you know, they tell you exactly how much caffeine is in each one of these.
Yeah, and what we did there was
that little flex on the back, and there's even a QR on it to be able to look more into the brand.
Yeah, there's, and it's just, you know, to answer his question further, it's just, we just cleaned it up. It's a much cleaner consumption, and honestly, you feel it. And we tried the competitors, and it's what really sparked us to formulate this and put this brand together. And, you know, our stuff doesn't wig you out. We keep you dialed in, and it's responsible. You can take two a day. Our concept is at 250 milligrams, anywhere from 400 to 600 milligrams is a responsible dosage, depending on the individual. So one in the morning, one in the afternoon. I mean, forget about it.
Forget about it. And also, again, no sugar, no carbs.
And,
I mean, you're talking about health benefits.
Yeah.
Diet friendly.
Yeah, diet friendly. We're saying you don't have to go to the fucking Starbucks and get that crazy chocolate covered sugar bomb, you know, venti.
All of your calories and
2,000 calories in a fucking cup. Shit. You can literally get the same deal that you need. There you go.
Well, I've got a health benefit to mention. I work in the health field. I work in orthopedics. So you come and see me when you break your arm. And guess what? I'd start my morning out with a camo every morning, no questions asked. And if I wouldn't, I'd be having a bad morning. But this helps me laser focus. So guess what? When you come in with your broken arm, I'm going to cast you better because I've had a camo.
There you go.
And that is your focus. Focus.
That's awesome. You know, yeah, that's the way to look. I'm the one you come to see when you mess your shit up, and I'm going to be there dialed in.
Here's another little fun fact, and this will be for all the kickballers on Sunday. When you've got too far into that bottle, if you're at tailgating, you're at a party, whatever it is, have a camo on deck because it will balance you out. And I know other people take a different route on the, you know, the China, the white train, but you can take a camo and it's going to balance you out.
And a little bit healthier and a little more legal, too.
And your jaw's not going to be as erratic.
It won't even age you. It won't even age your face.
Oh, shit. Oh, shit.
We saw what happened to George Young. We've seen the movie Blow. We get it. Thank you, Johnny Dick. Shout out.
Fantastic movie.
Yeah, yeah. Hey, Captain Awesome, which is his real name, by the way. It's his government legal name is Captain Awesome. It's not a joke. He says, I'll take pictures of my camo bottle at Alcatraz and the Golden Gate Bridge tomorrow. Bro, I hope you're being serious. And if you do that, we will seriously send you a case for the cool shots.
We had a guy that won camo for a year, and he resides in San Francisco. So.
Oh, shit. Yeah. How did he win it for a year? What was the competition?
It was just a contest, the whole like and follow stuff. And there was a male and female winner. And you know what?
That's proof that shit's real, everybody. Camo does it for real. Because some people go out there and say, we're going to have a contest, like and subscribe and follow, and we'll send you something. No, camo does it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. We do.
illSpin says I'm the camo caster. And that's cool because he's right. I'm the camo podcaster and the camo brace caster.
Just, you know, what's fun about all of this, guys, is we're all friends. Obviously, Rashad's our friend, and it just it's going to be so cool when this actually blows up, right?
No shit.
Because we're all part of it.
Captain Awesome is on it. He's really going to do it. And this guy pulls through. He once gifted our podcast little shot glasses that we could take like Jaeger bombs or any type of mixed drink. So if you did like a whiskey Coke.
Yeah.
And when you take these shots, it would swirl it down.
It would go into the,
mix it perfectly. Those things are badass. I still have them in my cabinet.
Come to our Halloween party and we'll use them.
Yeah.
Rachel's like in that back in the house. She says, Captain Awesome, can you please give it to a ghost at Alcatraz, please? Some form of ghost that's out there.
Hey, have you guys ever Moundsville, that prison?
Sorry?
I've never done that.
The tour up in Moundsville, when you're talking about abandoned jails.
Ooh, no.
Man, it's
is that weird. Here in? Is that here in West beautiful, Virginia. Wild, and wonderful West Virginia?
Yep. My fun fact here. I've had family members there, but my G-Maw was actually quite the gangster back in the 50s. So when we went up there and we were looking through the book, because you can see all the previous inmates, Rick's husband was in there. So
hilarious, dude. See, it's in your blood, man. It's in your bloodstream.
That's a whole nother podcast.
Hey, you're right about that. That's a whole other themed podcast, actually. It's not even called this anymore. Hey, while we've got some eyes on this, while we've got Camo here, why wouldn't we get weird again? It's round two of Family Feud. Here
let's go. Let's give some more Camo away. CamoEnergyShots.com. After this, we're going to do another little thing. We're going to try to see if we can guess. We're going to put it it in. See if we can guess when Gracie's baby pops out. And it's hanging on the vine. We're going to see when that
Thanksgiving.
Happens.
Gracie's still got one on the water hose. She's still got one on the hose.
And then we got a fun holler poll that's got some interesting questions answers that actually are going to probably set us all off on a little shots fire. It's going to be a lot of fun. So everybody stick around while you're chilling with us. Let's give you some free shit. What's up?
All right, here we go. First question. We're going to two. The first person to get two wins it, by the way. Here we go. Name something romantic partners negotiate. Name something romantic partners negotiate.
Okay. All right. Negotiation. Camo probably, you guys probably have to negotiate plenty of shit.
Exactly. I've had a super major retailer right now that's just busting my balls on pricing, but we may.
Yeah, so that's the thing. It's like, is it a back and forth when you talk to some of these retailers?
Because you're talking to these guys. You know, our concept at Camo is if you sell on price, you're going to lose on price. Okay, so we want to really, we want to really provide the whole package,
quality,
which is a competitive pricing, marketing, support, promos, everything that's going to drive sales. And that's when we start getting retailers to pay attention instead of just offering up and I'll make mine the cheapest out there. We don't do that.
No, fuck that shit. Yeah. I mean, because anybody could do that. Anybody could do that.
So,
but you guys are coming at it with this deal and it's actually perking their ears up a little bit.
Yeah. So, you know, the concept, if I sell on price, then I lose on price, meaning when JD's shots come out and he undercuts Camo, then I'm out the door, right? No, because Camo gave you the full package.
Yeah.
So JD may have a cheaper price, but who's really going to move the product?
And I'm cheap, baby.
Nobody's got the right answer. Do you guys need some Camo? Wake up out there. Keep typing words. Do you want to hear the question? You want to hear the question again? Name something that romantic partners negotiate. See, keyword romantic. They didn't just say couple. Name something that romantic partners negotiate. Hey, Adam, this reminded me when you were talking about like undercutting the competition. One of my favorite episodes way, way back in the day of Tom Green. Remember that show, the Tom Green show? He had this episode called Undercutter's Pizza, and he would hang out near this pizza place that would send out a delivery car, but in Tom Green's car for his stupid ass show that was just made up. It was essentially the first reality show, like essentially what it was. And he would have
Jackass, pretty Jackass.
It was. And he would have a tackle box in his car, and the tackle box had a bunch of pizza toppings like pepperonis and cheese and all this stuff. And he would have like a pre-made pizza in a box. Well, he would follow this poor delivery guy around, and when the delivery guy would pull up to someone's house, Tom Green would rush to the door, and he would say, "Hey, guys, I'm with Undercutter's Pizza. I can make your pizza right here. I'll give it to you $5 cheaper."
Hey, that's in those people actually exist in retail. From a distributor standpoint, they're called trunk slammers. It's a real
trunk thing. Slammers.
Yeah. So they would go in and try to undercut you with whatever energy shot they have. Absolutely. And now it's not as real time as Tom Green.
No, yeah, that's a little more.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was a little bit
called trunk slammers.
That's hilarious, though. I mean, who knew that that was going to pull up a real term? That's hilarious. Yeah. By the way, shockingly, nobody got this answer. We're going to have to move on.
Let's scooch to the next one. I will say this about Tom Green. One of my favorite episodes was when he was on one of those spring break cruises that MTV did. And it was a whole cruise ship, and it was his spring break episode, but he didn't talk to any kids. He just went into the bowels of the ship. And just kept talking to the maintenance guys. That was just the whole episode.
Back in the day when MTV used to hit all the islands and shit.
Mel, good night. Thank you for coming around.
The spring break thing or like their island trips or whatever?
All of MTV. I was down in the Bahamas at the time with a buddy of mine, Rocco Morabito. So,
word.
Yeah.
I bet that was full of shit.
We were actually on MTV getting interviewed by Ananda Lewis. That's how old it was.
Oh, wow.
I believe it, dude.
That's a call.
I was down at Panama City Beach, Florida on college spring break with my boys. And we were on a show called Dog Eat. What was it called? Dog Eat Dog?
Yeah, it was something about a car. It was like man eats something or
man eat. It was like man eat. I don't fucking
man
know.
Eat dog. Dog eat car.
Like, clearly, man I was inebriated. I don't remember the name of the show, but that was also an MTV show, and we were on it.
Wasn't it like anyway, Zach Galifianakis or something?
Exactly. They had people tricked into thinking it was like reality show, but it wasn't. It was scripted.
Yeah.
And so I got to see kind of behind the scenes of how that worked, even though I was like drunk as hell as they were trying to get me on the show. Anyway, here we go. Next question here. We're still looking for number one answer. Name an activity people like doing for hours at a time. Name an activity people like doing for hours at a time.
Fuck it. Well, get it?
Gracie, are you still alive out there? Yeah. Can you give us any type of update?
Any update on the baby stuff? Are you at centimeters now?
Number one answer is already in the chat. And we've been tell us about CAMO Energy.
Can you tell us about CAMO Energy, please?
Knox, have you made any deals lately? Hold on. Knox, I got you. Listen, Knox likes this one. Hold on.
What?
He likes... No, I've got your favorite. Hold on, let me look, Knox. Knox, I got you. Here you go. You ready?
Yeah. LeBron James.
He likes this one too.
All these, we have the meat.
Watch your movie.
We were having fun with the soundboard in the pregame.
LeBron.
LeBron James.
He's gonna say that for the next month, dude. You're welcome. He's gonna say it in your house.
That one's
fun. Number one answer is in the chat. Number one answer was TV. That's what people like doing for hours at a time. illSpin's on the board.
Boom. Boom, bam. Again, the score's reset, by the way. So illSpin, yep. Still got to get another one if you want to win the CAMO, dude.
Nice.
No doubt. Okay, here we go. Next question. Yeah, this is going to be whoever can type the fastest, I believe. I think this might be the easiest one of the night. Here we go. Name something you have to schedule. Name something you have to schedule. Should be a pretty quick one, guys. Here we go.
Hell yeah.
Nostalgia.
Hey, try that one, Fudge Round.
Yeah, try that one. Number one answer is already in the chat. Number one answer is already in the chat. And by the way, that's gonna end up being your CAMO winner tonight.
Miranda.
Boom, he'll spin again. Winner.
That'll save us.
You know what? That happened, dude. That happened last week. He won it last week, and I actually went up to his tent and I was like, "Here you go, man. Here's your winning."
Here you are.
So, bro, in the chaos, illSpin, in the fucking absolute chaos, you'll be on the other side of the field because, you know, you'll be on the champion side of the field because that's who you are right now. You're number one, dude. And I will come over as the number two. I'll come over to your side of the field, and I will hand you your camo, and nice. I will wish you well.
How nice you are to do that.
I wish you well.
All right, yo, we're gonna do some little guessing to see. We'd like to get a report back from Gracie. She's probably pretty busy right now because it is going down. But we are going to put our names in the hat here. We're going to see what other people got to say about that. We got a holler poll for you. We're going to talk some shit. CamoEnergyShots.com, everybody. Let's do this. Brian, give me a fun button to take me on to the next movement. That's good. That's just the drums from Phil Collins in the
interview. That's all you need.
That's all you need. That's the song everybody wants anyway.
Don't overthink it.
Don't ever think. So, okay. So, Gracie again. Baby watch. 2023.
One on the vine. Gracie.
Hashtag one on the vine.
illSpin. Wave that thing around, Gracie. illSpin says, I'm the Patrick Mahomes of a holler trivia. Hell yeah, dude. I love that. Yeah.
Holla, holla. It
would be great if his receivers would catch him.
I think he's the Jared Goff of.
Yeah. Maybe. Fuck.
Listen, man.
Yeah, he's definitely not the Tony and catching.
Tough.
Okay, so we're all three going to make a guess, right, for what time the baby is going to arrive. That's where we're at, right? That's what we're doing?
Exactly, yes. I think, personally, that little John Bryan, a.k.a. Finn, his real name, but it's little John Bryan, will actually probably arrive, like, tomorrow at 9 p.m. I say, like, 9 p.m. She's going to have to deal with all this shit for almost like a whole nother 20.
Oh my God,
hours.
Suffering. You hear that, Gracie?
Suffering. 22 hours from now, that's when it's going to. So, yeah, tomorrow evening, 9 p.m. or later is what
I've had. Adam, what do you think? Two babies in my career. I'm going to call. If she's at a 2 right now, I'm going to say 6 p.m.
Ooh, that's a good guess. 6 p.m. tomorrow.
So,
that's
wait, you just prices righted me then.
Yeah. I'm like,
you just Bob Barker'd my ass, bro. Like, what's up, dog? So then Brian's gonna undercut you too.
Hey, JD, the price is wrong, bitch.
All right, Brian. I mean, what's up? What do you think, dude? Like, what's up?
I am going to go. I'm going to give Gracie a little bit of a benefit of a doubt here. You guys are saying more suffering. I'm going to say less suffering, Gracie. She will give birth. I'm going to give a better time, too, by the way, because I'm trying to win. I'm trying to win
right,
this thing.
Right.
I'm going to say Gracie will give birth to baby Finn, a.k.a. little John Bryan, around, let's call it 2:55 p.m. tomorrow, the live birth of baby Finn. 2:55 p.m.
You wanted to say 3, but you wanted to get a little more particular with it. But it's literally across this board here, Brian at 3 p.m., Adam at 6 p.m., and me at 9 p.m. So I'm the one thinking it's going to be a long boy. Brian's thinking I'm thinking it's going to be 6 more hours of suffering. And then now they're starting to roll in. So let's see what's – so Miranda, she says he's popping out, literally in 4 hours. Is what she says.
Ooh, that'd be a tough break.
I mean,
Gracie.
He's gonna be kicking it. He's gonna be like kicking out of there, like fucking.
That's gonna require emergency C-section to hit that.
It might happen. Might happen.
illSpin says 9 a.m. Okay, so I see that everybody's going in these like 3-hour increments. I kind of like it. It's interesting.
Actually, to be clear, illSpin said 9:09 a.m. with 23 seconds is actually what he said.
I like that. Are you marking these down, by the way? Because all the ones we've got like in the chat and, you know, are there, but also the ones saved in the comments, those are all set. We've got timestamps on all those. Those are all legit. So we'll know.
100%. And I'm marking them down too, by the way. I'm doing Gracie's job while she's doing a job.
And what we've done, though, by the way, just to let everybody know, and we said this in the beginning of the show, but this is to confirm it. the closest to the actual time of birth is going to get a camo pack, straight up, like real deal, good ass prize. We're gamifying Gracie's birth process is now becoming a viral moment on the internet.
And we are mocking the umbilical cord for I don't know why, but we're doing that.
Hashtag one on the vine.
Man, I hope Gracie's getting this. We might cause the baby to come out faster.
Try that in a fudge round.
Try that one in a fudge round, Gracie.
I've never had a baby.
Baby Finn?
But I.
She's never had a baby, but she doesn't know, man. She just likes that guess. It's interesting. So y'all keep throwing them out if you want. That's great. And again, if you put them in the comments, they're saved there. It's cool. And if it's all there, we'll go through them. Whatever's the closest, you'll get a free camo variety pack.
Who said that, Miranda?
It's wonderful shit. So I did have so that was actually our first holler poll. You didn't realize it, y'all, but that was the first holler poll was, is Gracie's baby going to be here tonight? Tomorrow? Give us a time.
Hey, B-Ball, Miranda's booty's in the third trimester, so I don't know.
Man, somebody, we were just talking about it just tonight, so now we're back. We're back on the peach. You know, peach, what a great flavor.
Damn. So the other holler poll that we had this evening was one that I put out there, and this is one that I'm pretty glad, actually, we put this one with the other one, because this is going to be one that's going to kind of turn it. Miranda says, Adam, come on, man.
Only compliments. That's all I have.
Girl, that booty. So this is the other question, or the other poll question we had. But it's also going to end up turning into a sort of what's going to end up becoming it. So, Brian, can you go ahead and just give me the OG shots fired? Give me the shots fired.
Oh, okay.
I need it, because that's what this question is. It's straight up set up for the shots fired. All of us are going to know the answer. We're going to have it all great ones. It's going to be dope. Give me that fucking juicy business, bro.
Yeah, I got you, man. I hadn't hit the button so long, I couldn't find it. Here we go.
Shots fired. Shots fired.
Energy shots.
Shots fired.
CAMOEnergyShots.com.
Y'all, we're giving you so many opportunities to win the stuff. Look at those new beautiful labels, y'all. For real. Look at the lids on that shit. It's popping off. It's popping off, y'all. It looks like
a flash.
I think we're at a strong 6 to 8 months on the lids alone.
Word. I'm loving it.
Oh, yeah.
I'm loving it so strong. We're giving you all so many opportunities to get free camo shots. Just hit us up. By the way, we do this all the time. Officialholler.com, CAMOEnergyShots.com. We want to hook you all up. We want you all to know about these and try them and tell your friends and all that good stuff. So just stick with us. We'll show you the damn way. You know what I'm saying? So
Church.
The poll question this week, and it's going to end up becoming a shots fired, and I think you're going to really like it. Adam, I know you'll like this one, is what is a total waste of money that people still have to pay for or still pay for? It's a total waste of money, but people still do it. People still have to do it, or maybe they're forced to. Maybe they choose to, but it's still just a waste of damn money. Why are we even doing it? So what is a total waste of money that people still pay for? And I'm going to go ahead and just shout a couple quick ones out, then come back to us so we can go with our answers. And then I want to go with the stronger answers, too, from some other people. So here's some quick ones. Total waste of money. People still pay for it. Corey says lottery tickets. Sophie says pyramid schemes. I like these answers very much so. Lee Pennington, what's up? Friend of the pod. She says Uber Eats, but I'm very guilty of that. illSpin popped in and said McDonald's. Word.
McDowell's.
Aranda, top fan, what's up, girl? She says taxes. Dang.
What you got against McDonald's? What's going on?
Well, it's a total waste of money,
But you can't stop
I'm
it.
Hungry.
He's saying you just can't
stop. I'm fucking starving. Here's the problem. Tell me I'm not going to eat a double cheeseburger.
A total waste of money because it used to be a $2.99 meal. Now it's a $9.99 meal.
Yeah.
That's the issue.
And they put sugar in everything. McDonald's, and we figured that out. We were like, why does McDonald's taste so good? Oh, yeah, they put cocaine in it. They put crack in it. No, they put sugar in everything.
Even the
– They put – sugar. Hey, there's definitely sugar in the ketchup. Most ketchup is sugar anyway. But even they put sugar on the fucking burger patties in the chicken. You know they do it.
I'm an Indian outlaw.
So you guys see where we're going with that idea? Oh, illSpin said the cheese is 17% plastic. The other 83% is
sugar.
Sugar.
Plastic sugar. So y'all see where we're going with this, right? Like, what's a total waste of money that everybody still kind of gets in?
Yeah, yeah.
Do you guys have anything? Is there any? Brian, go ahead, bro. What's up? This is shots fired. This is fun.
It really is. That fucking Apple storage that we all pay for, where there's like $3.13 coming out of my account, and it's like it's this minute amount that like doesn't bother me enough, so I don't change it. But the truth is, I don't need to pay for that. There's plenty of free storage methods all over the internet. I'm an app download away from just making that go away. But instead, I'm like, $3. But guess what, dude? $3 times 3 million people.
Yep.
30 million people.
That's called the come up.
Yes, the come up. Right. It's times once a month for 12 months every single year, times base your quarterly earnings on that shit. That's some Apple shit. That's very true.
It's some Apple ass shit. That's those trunk slammers we were talking about earlier. That's Apple.
Yeah, you gotta watch them little trunk slammers.
That's me shooting.
That's good.
Apple.
That's good. Because I'm next on this one. I'm gonna do mine on this one. And this one might, I don't think it's gonna be necessarily a controversial, but I will say this. Oh, illSpin's already popped. He just keeps coming with them. illSpin. Rashad says Tinder add-ons.
That's a pretty funny one, actually.
You actually be paying for that shit, bro? What's that?
That's where illSpin. I thought he gets his illSpin on the app.
Hey!
illSpin, I thought you were married, man. How do you know about Tinder add-ons? How do you know about that?
For everyone to see and all that stuff. Patrick Rousey, he popping in saying Sirius XM.
Absolutely, yeah, absolutely on that one. Yeah,
I can understand that, especially if you're doing all the other kind of services and stuff. Like the only thing that they've got that everybody else doesn't have is like it's still old school radio, so there's still some form of curation from other people, you know, all that shit. They're rolling in right now. Damn. Patrick also says car apps that replace auto starts. Wait.
Like you can start your car from like your...
From your Bluetooth, right?
Oh, yeah, that's what he's talking about. Like, so, but like, dude, they charge you like a service fee. He's right about that. They charge you a service fee for like having the app.
Start your own car in the winter? Fuck those people, man. That's bullshit.
You know what I'm saying? Like, what if you didn't fucking pay your like app bill? You can't fucking start your car. Right. You're like,
popped in. He's going to name his next band the Trunk Slammers. Party hard.
My bad.
Royalties, please.
Blast them. You're going to be blessed. All right. So my answer for this one, and these are my shots fired here. What is a waste of money that people still pay for? Netflix. There are so many other different fucking versions of all these streaming shits. When's the last time? Now, and the only reason you're paying for Netflix is because of some shit that Netflix made that you probably forgot that you paid 6 months worth of Netflix for, and you finished it when you fucking did your last binge.
Yeah.
And now you're waiting on the next fucking, season or whatever, and you're still paying for that shit every month. This is what you do. You get on Netflix, you pay for it, you binge everything quick, then you cancel. And then you don't do it again until months later when everything's
back out. You want to watch something?
Keep the cycle going.
It's different with, like, Disney, because I'll watch Star Wars all day long. I'll watch Avengers all day long. I'll watch some shit like that all day long. And also, for the kids, if you got kids – you got to get you got to keep Disney.
So your hat would be a contradiction then.
My hat is just very fun.
All right, I see you, illSpin. I got it. That was not right, a personal you question. You know, it's
for a friend. I say Netflix, asking for a friend. Netflix is a waste. Everybody keeps paying for it. You know, that's my word. BBLs. Adam, how about you? What is a waste of money that people still pay for and still?
Those are a waste, illSpin.
I would. So I'm a car whore. And I think it's expensive cars because sometimes it kind of registers like, am I really paying this much money? And for me, like, there's not a lot of travel other, you know, than in a plane or something, but it's pretty much for me is the kids, school drop off, the gym, warehouse, home, soccer. Mm-hmm. This cycle keeps going. So I really need the vehicle that I'm in. So, I think it's just overpriced vehicles. And I love cars, love vehicles. I'll probably always be a victim of this, but it is obnoxious how cars are priced these days.
Especially these motherfuckers that are like they're trying, you know, the used car market is weird as fuck right now because you got, dude, that's a high mileage vehicle. You got over 100,000. On that shit, and you're asking for fucking 15 grand still? Yeah. What's nuts, the fuck, dude, bro?
So my little trick to all of this is leasing, which would be a whole nother podcast and why I lease, but it's the best play for me to protect me on my car impulses.
Especially if your budget's good. If you got the budget for it, that's the way to go with it. But if you're trying to straight up, you know, that's true.
Hey, JD, I've got another answer for you. This one comes from my softball team. One of my teammates was just talking about this, and it blew my mind. You and I don't have children, so we don't deal with this. Maybe Adam has heard of this. I don't know.
Right.
But apparently, these parents that have to drop their children off at daycares. So think about this. You wake up in the morning. You've got to get your ass to work. That's already bad enough, right? You got to get there early in the morning.
Yeah.
But you need to drop your child off at some type of daycare so that you can get to work. Well, the conundrum is the daycare place for my softball buddy, the place like starts at 8 a.m. Well, he's got to be at work at 8 a.m. So he's got to obviously drop his child off sooner and then he's still got to go to work, right? Well, if he drops his child off 20 minutes early, they charge him for an entire hour. What the fuck is that?
Yeah. No mercy. No mercy. What
the fuck is that?
No mercy.
Mercy.
Yo. But they have to deal with your kids. So that's the deal. I mean, that's the trade-off, right?
Can we get like a prorated
rate? Does no, you can't. No, they say straight up, no. We bring the hellion in. We're charging
it. Well, fine. In that case, you're getting them 59 minutes early.
No, what you're really doing is paying those childcare workers to put their phone down early
before
the day starts.
Yeah, yeah. To get the fuck off the phone so they can Patrick says they can also charge you for the weeks you aren't there or even close.
Can we talk about his profile pic? I mean, that's like homecoming 08, right?
That's word. What up, dude? Well, yeah.
That's Bill Clinton and Monica Lewinsky in that photo. I mean,
that just screams couples only. I love it.
So, yo, here's
the, you look dapper. All right,
that's wonderful. Can you give me one more shots fired button here? Can you get a lot? I need a little bit more bullets. More bullets. These are coming from Holler Nation. Thank you guys so much for answering this good stuff. This is great. These are everyone's answers for what's a total waste of money that people still pay for, or that people are forced to pay for, or things like that. But it's just a fucking waste of money. This one's interesting only because of the joke that's inside of it. Patrick says garbage pickup. But then Aaron comes in and says, how dare you speak of your father that way just because I pick him up? That man is a saint. That's good shit. So these next ones, they started a little bit of a ruckus in the comment section, which is fun because welcome to Facebook, everyone. So Austin says, rent, honestly. If we were taught about loans and business in school the way we should, you know, that this kind of a house would have a mortgage of this much a month to pay that house off instead of basically burning all that money you do per month and rent goes toward nothing, would have helped us all out tremendously. couple other people got in there and said, I don't know what you're talking about with this and that and, you know, blah, 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 blah. But, yo, that is gnarly. Rent is nuts. If you can afford – but that's a whole other thing, too, because you can't buy a house without them saying you have – you have to have great credit. You have to have income, guaranteed income for so long, which is understandable. But all these other things and then all of a sudden you're buying a house with bad leaks and bad foundation for three times what it used to be fucking 10 years ago. So whatever. Emmy comes in and she says, now this one's real. Oh, we say, oh, here we go. Gracie, what's that? Sure will. Like when you go on vacation and still have to pay your rent or mortgage.
I think she's talking about the child care.
Oh, thing I see.
Talking about.
I see. Yeah. You know, that's an interesting thing. Do you really, how do y'all feel about that? If you're going on a 2-week vacation, you're not going to be using the house. Do you need to pay rent for it?
Not going to be using. Well, someone else
yeah,
going to be there.
Like, it's like, you know. You got to move all your shit out, go on vacation, then come back and move all your shit back in. I don't know, but this one's really cool though. I really like this one, and this is great because it's coming from like straight up from like the real deal shit. Emmy Yates, she says diamonds is one thing that a total waste of money. People still pay for that shit. She says that she worked in the industry. She says the employee discount is that you don't pay for the diamond at all. You just pay for the gold it sets in. So that $4,000 ring is only worth $700. That's gnarly. That's some fucked up
I
shit.
I like that answer.
Because you're thinking you're investing, right? You're thinking you're putting all this money against it, you know, but damn.
Dude, and here's a weird way to look at this diamond thing, man. I got something to say about this. So now they can artificially make diamonds, and they look legit. They look legit.
Oh, but they're humans, more flawless. They're flawless.
They're actually better, right?
They're better than the blood ones.
Nobody fucking died because of this.
Yeah.
Nobody died. But like, you know, it's crazy. So what the fuck do humans have built into them where they're like, no, give me the one where like this ruined this family's life and this guy got his arm chopped off. I want that one.
Give me the one where they just throw all that human death and suffering toward and find me this.
And I'm going to pay extra. That's how much I want. I'm going to pay a lot extra.
Fuck that shit. That's so sick.
What the fuck are we doing?
Nikki, what's up, Nikki?
I didn't
know
that was a thing. Wow.
How are you doing? She says cable television. That's a really good answer. Very solid. I don't think anybody would
I just
protest.
Made the switch from DirecTV to YouTube TV, and I'm very excited about that.
Right.
I went from, because I have eight TVs in the house.
Right.
So I was what I was paying in the rental fee on all
yeah.
the hardware
yeah.
was more than what I'm paying for
just
YouTube TV,
just
stream through
the service.
Yeah. I went from almost $300 to $72.
There you go. And now Rachel's calling back about this whole deal with the child care shit. And this, you know what? So this is where it kind of works here. So Rachel, she says, if I have a client booked for an hourly service, I charge for the hour no matter the time. If they come in and it only takes 10 minutes to do it, she charges for the hour. Yo. That's word.
Well, she cuts hair, and I think in her industry, man, I mean, especially like, I'm not knocking anyone's industry, by the way.
I don't know. You kind of sound like you're knocking on these childcare, these people. They keep their eye on you.
Dad's got to get to work. Dad's got to get to work.
Daddy's got to get to work. Okay. I only got a couple more, and then we'll scoot on and we'll finish this one up. It's good. DJ Allspin says Hulu TV is top notch.
I went with YouTube. Hulu is very strong. It's Hulu or YouTube. I went with the YouTube.
Yeah. Give yourself that NFL back.
And here's your sort of black sheep of the family, Fubo. Fubo, pretty good. Fubo, not bad.
Yeah.
Fubo, nice. Check it out. All right. Maverick says insurance, car insurance specifically. First of all, your rates are based on the dumbest things, not just your type of your car, right, your area, or the deer population, but baseless stuff. Like the color of paint that's on your car, your age, your gender. 90% of people pay in and never actually end up using their policy. If you just put back the amount you spend on insurance in a savings account every month and the off chance something happened and you have to use it, you would likely have more than enough to cover the expense of what happened. Damn. That's a big
exactly.
That's that, a yeah, big what, statement. That's pretty. Facts. I think that's pretty facts. That's I think pretty. Facts. All right, I'm going to say that one more time. If you just put back the amount you spend on insurance in a savings account every month, and the off chance something happens and you have to use it, you would likely have more than enough to cover the expense.
Damn.
That's a great way to explain that, by the way. That's a great explanation.
I just destroyed your name, DJ Lips Pimps. She said, I've probably paid over $50,000 in car insurance over the last 15 years, and I only had a couple windshields, a door panel, and a bumper replaced. All that totaled around $2,200.
1,000%. And by the way, I feel that way about health insurance. Me, myself, personally, I've had like two prescriptions in 10 years that probably cost like $10, and I've paid like $100,000.
And here's her last little statement here. But if you don't have the insurance, you go straight to jail. That's fucking horse shit.
You go straight to jail.
And then a mutual friend popped in. His name's Damon. He popped in. He said, let's not mention the fact that you have an insurance credit rating. That's wildly different from your actual credit rating.
This is real great. Bullshit.
Patrick says, insurance saved my ass when my car caught on fire, especially after it caught eight others on fire as well.
Well, damn. If you burn the block down, insurance got your back.
Well, damn.
Here's Farmer's Auto. We've heard it all. I believe if I'm not
we've mistaken, seen a thing or two like nine people catching on fire.
If I'm not mistaken, on a Monday morning, if I'm not mistaken, Patrick came out. He started his car with one of those phone apps, and there was a raccoon in his engine.
And he drank some gasoline earlier.
Why? Hey, well,
it popped like the Hindenburg. The whole place fucking all the raccoonity.
All right.
Only got a couple more here. Seth, this is his answer. Water. What is something that is a total waste of money that you still got to pay for? You got to pay for water, people. It's, you know, it is true. It does that get seems piped correct. To your place, but, you know, it is fucked up. Well, all need it. Somebody's got to lay that pipe. The whole planet needs it. We need it. It turns out the amount of water on the planet is also the amount of water in our bodies and how that all works out.
It's also super cheap. The issue with water is, I mean, everything they have to do to treat the water before it gets to your house. True. That's where all the fees add up.
This is very true.
And without it, you'll die, by the way.
Corey says haircuts.
Edge interesting.
Up? I don't know. Rachel might not like that one. Damon also popped into that one and said, I don't know, man. As a vain dude, I do hate a bad haircut.
Yeah, dude.
So, all right, these next ones. This one also comes from Damon as well. He says, insurance on your phone, specifically phone insurance, or even a new phone every 2 years. I'm guilty of the latter, but I know a guy that will give me insurance and a claim the same day. Do we really need a new phone every year, or are we all just suffering from FOMO? That's word. Probably. That's straight. Yep. That's what's up. Damon, good shit. On these last two are fun. Jason, what's up, dude? Owner of Bar None downtown. Good place. Go party over there. His answer, Starbucks. What's your money? It's a pretty good one. Or coffee, like specialty coffee for that matter. Especially if you're just rolling in there and getting the same shit every day. That's word. Gym memberships. Word. Yeah, just lift up heavy shit. Walk around the block. Run around the block, lift heavy shit. What's up?
I knew someone that got discounts on their health insurance or their health insurance paid for their gym membership. That would make sense. That's I would feel better smart. About well, paying for my health insurance.
Well, it's insurance, right? Wouldn't they it's be mutually, wouldn't they have a vested interest in you being a healthy you would hope person?
So. You would hope so, but it feels like it's a fucked up business.
The most companies they'll have a credit towards a wellness program to obviously drop the premiums on their insurance. But yeah. What's funny about gym memberships is the only group out there that's killed it is Planet Fitness because what they do is they ding you every month. What is it, like $9.99 or some shit?
$10.
So mentally you're like, I've got a membership. I'm good. I'm going to go next week. I'm going to go next month.
No, you don't.
And it's a fantastic business model because if you really step back and look at it, they operate at 7% capacity
in their facilities.
Yeah, I heard that if everyone came, I heard that if everyone came, it would be a fire hazard. Yeah. They wouldn't even have enough.
Yeah, room. Bingo.
So, and they bank so on that.
Taco night also, would be a hot mess if they actually
Also, every 2 weeks, they have a pizza party in the gym.
They do have a pizza party. Yeah. They're keeping
inside of the gym. They're going to get you fatter to lose the weight.
Head on over to the pizza room after you bench
press. You get a good mental sweat.
Yeah. There you go. That's what this podcast is for. This is the last one here. What's a total waste of money, but people still have to pay for it? This final one comes from Emma, and she says, living.
Ooh.
Nihilism, baby. That's all you got to do.
Nihilist.
I saw, what do you guys think of this? I saw a video online where a McDonald's had installed like pedal seats. So while you're sitting there eating McDonald's, you're pedaling like a bicycle.
Yes, I saw that.
I don't like that.
Would you pedal for cheaper food?
All right. You know what?
I don't think it was in the U.S. though.
All right, hang on. Here's the deal. What's stopping me from going and buying a Big Mac and then jogging and eating it? I'll tell you what's stopping me. I will throw up. I will sit there and jog and be like, it's a wonderful day. I'm going to enjoy this Big Mac. And then just two bites into that thing, the tummy and then it's just blah.
Could you imagine looking over beside you? You're trying to like cram a lunch at McDonald's, and there's like a businessman. And he's in a full suit. He's fucking pedaling away, eating his Big Mac. He's just fucking sweating his shirt, stopping.
He's still holding onto the briefcase just in case he needs to check his file.
So he's running in place like Lloyd and Harry. He's like, I'm running
at Rashad popped into it. He said, I saw a guy eating a slice of pizza on the elliptical machine once at Planet Fitness.
And then Pat, I guess it was Pat.
It turns out it was Pat. There you go. Oh, he says, great piece of paper.
And there we go. And that's how we should say. That's the end of the segment.
That's where Pat that really is how we should 08 profile.
Cap the whole. Dude, Adam, CAMO Energy, is there anything else that we need to get out before we just close this night out? What do the people need to know?
We're on the move. We're on the rise. You know, it's fluid like every time you guys have me on here, which is a good thing. It's next Wednesday, there's a monumental meeting with a major retailer that would start to make CAMO a household name. That's what I'll leave you with.
Cool. Good luck, dude. Wonderful. Seriously.
Thank you.
That's so cool.
Yeah, you guys are fantastic, man. We appreciate the hell out of the sponsorship, and we love giving this stuff away. I love consuming it. It makes me a better professional, and that's no joke. Right. At my job every day, I fucking love it. It makes you a better kickball player.
We love being able to show new people about this all the time. It's so dope, like doing this show and bringing CAMO with us and making it all happen. Rachel, what's up? Thank you so much. Thanks for hanging out with us. It's so cool to be able to introduce this brand that everybody is going to love. You try it once, you're a fan instantly. This is that shit that's like straight up. Why did I fuck with the other shit before? This is the shit.
We got more pick ideas rolling in. illSpin says, I'll try to get a pick in Columbus at 934 Fest tomorrow before our set. Yeah, hell yeah, dude. That'd be awesome.
Oh, yeah.
That'd be sweet.
Sure, absolutely. And once again,
as long as
I'm in the know, I can tell the marketing team they'll pull all that stuff over and just keep this thing jumping.
Yeah, no doubt. Shall we smash a bunch of buttons and
we're
get
loving
out of here?
It, y'all. Guys. Everybody, CAMOEnergyShots.com, officialholler.com. Follow us on all socials. If you are watching us now, again, send us a little screenshot of you watching this show. We'll send you some CAMO. Straight up, guess Gracie's pregnancy, the pop-off date. It's a pop-out date. Pop-off.
He's still on the cord. Gracie's on the cord right now.
If you guess that and it's close to it, we're going to send you a big package of it. Yeah.
Guess when that cord's getting chopped. Gracie, we love you. Holler
Gracie,
Nation, we love
you.
We're going
to
smash.
We give you – I do want to sign off with this, though. Gracie, thank you so much for being cool with us and letting us do this. She obviously – everybody is going to be taking a big chunk of time off from the show But the show's never going to change. It's still going to be Holler. We're still proudly powered by CamoEnergyShots.com. She's still pregnant. She's getting her service.
And that's definitely how we're going to end with Gracie's cervix, everyone.
Gracie's cervix is Gracie. Ripening as we speak, everybody. CamoEnergyShots.com, OfficialHoller.com. So much fun. We'll see you all next time.
I love that Holler is being streamed in a hospital right now at the baby.
What?
Chili dog, outside taste freeze.
Sweet.